Hi, I'm Mary Poplin with Boris Effects, and today I'm going to show you parameter tracking using Mocha inside of the new Sapphire 2020. Sapphire features powerful Mocha planar tracking to drive parameters inside of lens flare, edge rays, rays, luna, grunge, spotlight, aurora, zap, muzzle flash, and free lens. Parameter tracking isn't limited to a single location. Multiple points can be tracked all at once, as seen here in the zap filter. I am going to show you these techniques in After Effects, but they work basically the same in all hosts. Apply the effect, use Mocha for parameter tracking, and adjust your effects controls. Mocha parameter tracking in Sapphire can drive a lens flare hotspot and pivot. It can provide motion for the 4 points along the zap spline and can place the moon in Luna. There's a million applications for this great new feature. So let's show you how parameter tracking works. For my first example, I will show you how to add a sun to this shot with S lens flare. First, we drag and drop lens flare onto our clip in the timeline in After Effects. Next, I click the Edit Mocha button. In Mocha, you can see I am in the Essentials mode. You can also see I have a pivot search area and center point, and a hotspot search area and center point. I will take the pivot point and the hotspot point and drag them to the location I want them at. But I can drag the search area wherever the texture is in the scene that will give me the movement for those points. Mocha is a planar tracker, but that's just a fancy way of saying a texture tracker. As long as the texture is moving uniformly, I can rest assured the Mocha tracker will lock onto that location. For the pivot point, I will track the ground plane, and here's a really cool trick. In Layer Properties, I can go to Link to Track and select None, and this will unparent the shape from the track. This means every pixel that moves beneath that shape will read like a scanner and drive my pivot center point without me having to animate the shape as the ground plane moves off screen. Now I will drag my hotspot point to the mountains on the left side of the car, because I can see in my shot that those BG details are not as obscured by the foreground car, and because they're BG elements, I know I can just track translation and basically get the track of the camera movement for free, which is good, because there's no clouds in the sky to track for my sun. Now I hit track forwards, and this has been sped up so you don't have to wait. And I can simply save and close Mocha, which will apply the tracking data back in my host. Back in AE, in my effects controls, I can adjust my lens flare details to my liking or use a preset, and my lens flare will track beautifully with my scene. Make sure to check Hotspot uses Mocha to ignore the XY position parameters and apply that Mocha position to the hotspot. You will also want to use Bypass Mocha to avoid using a Mocha mat to confine the lens flare. I can now open the lens flare designer and browse to a new effect, or I can edit one myself in detail. The lens flare designer is a wonderful tool with endless possibilities. So, while you can use one of our great canned flares, you can also invent new ones that belong only to your personal toolbox. I can do the same thing for my headlights. I open Mocha, and with Edit Mocha, I select my light location and my light search area. Track, save, close, and I can even duplicate this effect and simply edit in Mocha and move the light to the other headlight. And it's perfect. We can also use Mocha to create occlusions for flares, create complex outdoor scenes, and add new lighting effects to scenes that transform them from bland to grand. But what do you do when you need to track multiple points and deal with occlusions? Let me show you using Zap, an amazing tool you may have seen on shows like The Flash. We are going to put lightning between our talent's hands with a little help from Mocha inside of Sapphire 2020. I am going to fast forward through the bulk of rotoscoping, but it took a good bit of time to do, as roto tends to do. First, I apply my zap effect. Then, I open the preset browser by clicking on Load Preset. There's tons of great presets available, and the looks run the gamut from spiky frost to magical electricity. I choose a look I like. In this case, I like Ataxia Allure. I can really dive into the effect and mess with varying endpoints, branchiness, curve amp, and wrinkle to get different effects. But we are going to focus more on tracking and rotoscoping for this demo to save time. Just know that you can use Zap for lightning, which is what you think of by default, but you can also turn parameters on and off for a more MoGraph look or something approaching ice. Now that I have my desired look, I can toggle the Mocha menu down, and under Bolts, I can hit the Uses Mocha checkbox to designate that the start and end points will both use Mocha. If I needed other points, I would need to click Use Mocha for every single point I needed. Then I click Edit Mocha. This will launch a new window. We have an Essentials mode I already showed you for Mocha, but in this case, I'm going to use the Classic mode because I have a lot of complex tracking in Roto to do for this shot. I can delete any unused trackers for points I do not need. In this case, everything but the start and end points. I will then take my tracking search area shapes and make them larger using the built-in transform tool. Then I will take my points and align them where I need them on this guy's hands. If I want to change these points in my host, I can always use the Mocha Offset in the plugin interface. We are going to track using translation only. Now I hit track forwards. In Mocha, it is normal to move the search area around if your tracking location moves off screen. Sometimes retracking over an area like this back and forth can help lock a tricky shot down, like this shot. You can also smooth point tracks in the plugin interface if you have jitter, but that's not needed here. I recommend saving and closing Mocha and saving the project file at intervals. Now we have to roto each of these fingers. I am going to use the magnetic spline tool to trace the fingers on each hand. Notice how I am grabbing areas that move similarly. If he were bending his fingers a lot, I would need to separate out shapes by splitting the fingers at the joints. But I only need to do fingertips and the backs of the hands. Right now, I am focusing on fingertips. Normally, I would say focus on tracking first and then roto. But as you can see, that's giving me limited results because these fingers move a lot. So my shapes don't really move as well with the fingers as I would like. That means we are going to have to track and roto at the same time, focusing on one finger at a time. So I will show you how that looks for this one pinky finger, and then I am going to fast forward through the rest of this roto. We can use Alt or Option and S to snap splines to the edges of this finger, or I can roto by moving points manually. Mocha creates keyframes on top of my track that reduce manual keyframing by up to 2/3 and can cut your roto time in half. Notice how I am making keyframes at the arcs of the animation instead of every single frame. This cuts down on roto jitter. Try not to flip points. Instead, keep the shape oriented in the same direction. Points at the end of the finger should stay there and not rotate around the finger for best results. Okay, now that I have the pinky rotoscoped, let's power through these other 7 fingertips and the backs of the hands. I am not going to be too picky about the backs of the hands because they're essentially garbage mats. But it is important that the finger roto is decently accurate. I can and will feather the mat in the plugin interface by using Blur Mocha, but that will only hide so many of my sins. Now we save and close Mocha. I will check Bypass Mocha off to use my Mocha roto, and also I will check Invert Mocha in order to hold the fingers out instead of having them mask the lightning inside those shapes. We can add light leaks over the top to match the colors of the lightning, and now we have a beautiful comp with a really rad lightning effect using Mocha parameter tracking. So you can see with just a few clicks and with the power of planar parameter tracking using Mocha inside of Sapphire 2020, you can really create some powerful effects with minimal effort, taking your visuals to the next level. Mocha parameter tracking is available inside of Lens Flare, Edge Rays, Rays, Luna, Grunge, Spotlight, Aurora, Zap, Muzzle Flash, and FreeLens. We'd love to hear your feedback, so comment below and let us know what other effects you'd like to see us add Mocha parameter tracking to. Thanks to Pickled TV for the footage. We really appreciate it. To learn more about all the new features and improvements in Sapphire 2020, head over to borisfx.com for more info.